And back in the back here, we have Mark Williams, who is welcome new to the area. Mike Williams. So, at this particular point, we have another dignitary here, and he's actually going to introduce Senator Murphy, and that's Brad Wilkins from the local GOP organization in Forsyth. Brad?
Good evening. Can you guys all hear me?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to put this down. I'm going to cause trouble if I try to put this voice over that microphone. The space-time continuum will break or something. It'll hurt somebody. I'm Brad Wilkins. I know most of you here one way or another. I feel like I'm amongst friends. I am the chairman of your local Forsyth County Republican Party. And every once in a while, I have the privilege of introducing a fellow Republican, an elected official, in a meeting like this. But again, I kind of feel that this group, you know, as it grows, a lot of us already know each other. And sometimes we get a little used to seeing our elected officials here. Today will not be the last, and it certainly has not been the first time that we've seen Senator Jack Murphy amongst us. And the funny thing is, the more familiar we get with our elected officials, we get a little bit spoiled because we see these guys with us. We get to ask them questions. In a county like Forsyth County, there's a great opportunity for us to get to know our elected officials. So I'm just going to take a couple quick minutes to tell you a couple things about Jack that you may not know or you may not have been thinking about when you came in today. And when I think about leadership, I think of two organizations for a man to learn leadership: business and the military. The military, the person learned, they swear an oath to uphold and defend our Constitution. They learn an honor code, they live by an honor code. Military leaders have to put other people ahead of their own interests. In business, to succeed, you've got to know the secret to American exceptionalism, which this young man knows about. The free enterprise system, capitalism, I'm going to throw it out there. To compete, you not only make a product and make a service and make it better than everybody else, but you have to know how to cut waste and cut it fast. And when you find somebody who's had both opportunities in their life to learn, to serve, and to lead, you probably have someone who might make a heck of a good public servant. And our Senator Jack Murphy's had both. He served 4 years in the U.S. Air Force. Then afterwards, he went on to a private career. He worked his way up through working to become a regional vice president. And then he took all that experience and he formed his own company, Radar Exterminating. And he took it from a fairly small business, I'm not sure if any business people here know how hard this is, and he worked about $100,000 a year to $7.5 million a year. So he's had the opportunity to, you know, grow and learn and experience a lot of things, and he took all that and he started serving us down at the gold dome. Jack served two terms in the assembly. And then in 2007, he was elected to serve us as Senator Jack Murphy. And if you want to know a little bit more about how he's governed and how he's served, just recently he's earned an award from the American Conservative Union Foundation for their 2013 Conservative Award for his service this last year. So I'm pleased to announce and to introduce, you guys can all stand up for a second. Come on, get some blood going here. Stand up, and come on. Our good friend, Senator Jack Murphy.
Well, I'm honored this evening, Gundy. We've got the big guns out here. We got Debbie here and the big guns here, so I'm honored to be here tonight. Also, we have my good friend, Mark Hamilton, Representative Hamilton, who I've known for years. He's actually the best friend at my wedding. Best man